you can fill things inside it if you cut the top off of it like a pumpkin. The African reference to the drinking gourd was code among the slaves for the Big Dipper, star constellation in the night sky. The idea was that if you headed in the direction of the Big Dipper at night and just kept going in that direction each night, you would eventually be moving north and find your way into Canada and could cross the border to freedom. I didn't know about this until I read about the description of this in the music when I bought the piece. I think it's an amazing story. And this is a complex work that shifts moods four distinct times in the piece, and I'll just explain what those are. The four different moods or themes of this is at the very beginning, you'll hear a very simple violin solo, which is the melody of Follow the Drinking Gourd from the spiritual, and that is depicting the yearning to be free. After that, a little bit of excitement builds in the music, and that's called anticipation. And then it calms down one more time with some beautiful melodies, and that's called reflection. And then at the very end, when it builds to a big crescendo and a big forte at the end, it's the celebration of freedom. Now, there will be several soloists in the violins and violas. We're going to have Azara Pedlik here, Oliver Chen, and Jimmy Key playing viola solos. We are going to start this piece. I wanted to start with something big and loud, but I really wanted you to hear. The students voted for playing this piece for you as an opening number, so it does start very soft. And Tim and David over here is joining us for the first time. Thank you, David Atanasov, for joining us on percussion. And Tim.
Thank you. Thank you.